Let's talk about any one quadrant to begin with. One vertex has to be at 0, 0. The other one can of course be at 0, 5. Okay, this is 0, 5. The other one can of course be at, in this case, this would be the square. So we can't count 5, 0 again. One is 0, 5. The other would be something like 3, 4. The other one can be something like 4, 3. So in each quadrant, such a square is possible where 0, 5, 3, 4 and 4, 3. Similarly, this side you will have minus 3, 4 and minus 4, 3. Here, this below you will have the counterparts with 0, minus 5. So in each quadrant, you can have 3 squares. So 4 quadrants, you can have 12 such squares. What matters is these 3 combinations are possible. And every such case will lead to a different square every time. 12. Thank you.